Moonlit Winter Scene Using Pastels
with Mr. G.
Okay, today we are going to be starting out with a brown piece of paper. That means we're going to be covering the whole canvas with our pastel drawings. So we're going to start out with four different colors. We're going to start out with a blue, kind of a darker blue. Then we're going to start out with a lighter blue. And then we have a white. It doesn't really look white, but it is. And then we're going to use a brown. And a little bit later, we're going to add some green, some dark green and some light green. So you'll see those colors as well. So make sure that you have those. And what we're going to do first is we're going to start out with trying to figure out where our moon is going to be. You can put your moon anywhere on the top. I'm deciding to put mine right here, and I'm noticing I'm not drawing it right now. I'm just giving you the idea of where my moon's going to be. Then I'm going to take my darker blue, and I'm going to go on the top part of my canvas. And I'm just going to scrub it down pretty good because we're going to have to cover that whole piece of paper, that whole brown piece of paper, and make it all blue. Notice how I'm kind of going over the moon right now? That means I'm going to use my lighter blue, like I'm using now, to go around the moon itself. So I can cover right up over this because what's going to happen is I'm going to draw that moon in a little bit later. So I'm going to use the side of my pastel. You notice how I'm doing that, using the side of my pastel. And that covers up a whole lot more space too. So watch, I'll cover the moon. I know where it's at now. And then I'm going to blend it. We know how to do this. So I'm going to start on the bottom, kind of in the middle there, actually. And then we're going to move up into the sky. So we're going to go from light to dark. And then we'll make sure that that dark is covering up all the brown paper. So if you don't cover up all the brown paper, just add a little bit more in until you get it. Using the side of your pastel, once again, is the best way to do it because that's how you'll get the most chalk. Now notice my finger has a lot of blue on it, so I'm going to choose a different finger, or you can just use a wet wipe and clean your finger off, and then you can start off. Just make sure that your finger's dry when you start to rub the pastel again. So you'll see I'm getting kind of a nice little blend here. Blend it all together. Now I'm going to take my white, and then I'm going to start making a hill of snow. So what I'm going to do is probably do two hills. That'll be make it kind of easy for you, rather than having one, because we want to have two hills to give a little bit of dynamic to your drawing. And so I'm just going to make two hills. You know how to make hills. We've done those before. And once again, using the side of my pastel, not the top of my pastel, but the side of my pastel, I get to put on a whole bunch more pastel, a whole bunch more white, a lot quicker and easier. And then what we're going to do is we're going to blend it. Now, once again, we're going to try covering up all of the brown with the white. So if you don't have enough, just keep adding some white, and then you will get to the point of covering it all up. Now we're going to add some evergreen trees. So if you look at the picture that I've done before, notice the top of all of the evergreen trees are about at the same point. So that's how we're going to start our evergreen trees. We're going to kind of pick a point on the skyline, and that's how we're going to go down from there. So you can see all the tops are all pretty much even. So watch what we do here. I'm going to take the green pastel, and I'm going to choose this spot right here, and I'm just going to kind of move down. And then you can kind of decide how big your tree is from here. You know, you could stop right here. You could keep going. Decide to stop about right there. And again, just choose to go from the very top down. And then this one is going to be a little bit smaller. And so what that does is that shows us depth. If you remember a class that we taught on depth a couple of years ago, if you were around, you know that making objects smaller is one of the ways that we show dimensional, three-dimensional objects. So if you choose to make a trunk in there, which is probably a good idea, you can do that. And notice the tops are all the same size. So I'm going to speed through these real quick. Remember just doing a triangular shape like we've done in the past with the evergreen trees. Now, if we remember where our moon was, it was right around in this area here. So I'm going to create a moon, just do a circle. Again, this probably doesn't have to be a perfect circle, although the moon probably is. When you're using pastels, you don't have to be very exact about things. Pay attention to how dirty your fingers probably are, and just use your cleanest finger to make the moon. Otherwise, you might end up with a green moon, and that might not be great. So I'm going to add just a little bit of a white curve on the bottom of this, just to give it some depth, some dimension. Now we're going to take that light green, and we're going to kind of make little back and forth strokes, because what we're going to do is we're going to show which side of the tree is getting the light. So if you can see where the moon is shining down from the right, from the top right side of it. So we're going to add a little bit of light to that, some highlighting. I'll finish up these trees because I kind of forgot to. Now we're going to pay attention to where the moon is. That's where the light is coming from, and it's shining down on the tree. So for here, it's shining down on the left side of the tree and the left side of this tree here. So I'm doing a little bit of pastel work with the light green, and that's showing the highlighting there. So we're going to add some highlights to the right side of the tree on this, as you saw the path of the lights going this way. So wherever the light is shining on the closest to, that's the side that we're going to do. Now we're going to add some snow to our trees. Because when we look around sometimes in the wintertime, especially after it snows, we see lots of snow on top of the evergreen trees. That makes them look very pretty. So what we're going to do is we're going to go this rock, kind of a back and forth rocking motion like this. Back and forth, with just a little bit going on at each time. And we'll add that to all of the trees with this little rocking back and forth motion. Kind of see how that goes. Just like that. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to add some shadow. So if we look at shadows on snow, it's blue, and you can see where the light is coming from, that the shadow is going to be on the opposite side of whatever the object is. So we're going to very lightly take the blue and add it on top of the snow. Don't do that very hard at all, because it'll make a lot of color just with a little bit of light. So you want to start with a really light amount of it, and then just kind of pull it away. And then we're going to add a little bit of this brown that's going to add a little bit darker shadow kind of on that side of the tree where it's going to be a little bit darker. And that'll add a little bit more dimension to our drawing. We'll do the same thing with this little tree. Pay attention to where the light is coming from. And then just kind of pull away and add a little bit of the brown in there, just underneath the tree. And then you can take your finger and just pull it in the same direction, like that, just very lightly. And we'll finish this, do the same thing with all the rest of the trees. And one of the last things we're going to do is add just a little bit more of a highlight on the top of the hill, because that's where the moon is hitting the most. And so we'll just take some white. And if there's areas of your drawing that needs to have a little bit more snow, absolutely add some more. I think that I made the mistake of not covering the in between the hills a little bit more. I think I could have done that a little bit better. And then finally, we're going to add some stars. Stars are probably one of the easiest things to do, right? You just kind of tap them down wherever you'd like to, using the very tip of your pastel, kind of the sharpest part right there.
Thanks for watching!